We have represented here the three axes of the 3D space in cavalière perspective. Here is the vanishing line, and here is the slider commanding the coefficient of this perspective, which is the unit of the first axis. We have constructed first the point M with these three numbers we have created, numbers attached to A, number attached to R, and number attached to Z, and with the sliders. After that, with the tool text, we have created the expression R times cos A and R times sin A. We have evaluated this expression for the value of R and A displayed here and here, and obtain this number. After that, we have constructed the point having these three numbers as three coordinates in this space and obtain this number. This point is a point having these two coordinates in the horizontal plane. We have constructed then this segment. What happens if we change the value of A? You can notice that the bounds of slider A are 0 and 360, and here the bounds of R are 0 to 10. If we change the angle A, you can see that point M, both point M, are moving probably on a circle. And to check that, we will use the trace. First of all, let us decrease the value of R. R, everybody knows that it's the distance of OM in true dimension. So if we go to the tool, and if you use the tool trace, geometry trace of this point, and if we change the value of A, you can see that really we obtain the representation of a circle in cavalière perspective. If we use the tool trace for this segment, if we draw slider A, we obtain the representation of a cylinder. If we use the tool trace now for the upper point M and drag again this cursor, this slider, sorry, you obtain the upper circle of the cavalière perspective. Let us delete all these constructions, all this trace, sorry, with erase geometry trace, and let us construct the segment SM, the segment from S to M, and use the trace of this segment before dragging this slider here, and you see that we can obtain the representation of a cone. In the problem of the trace is that this construction are dead construction. If we change the position of the vanishing line, this figure would not follow our construction. So we need later to use the tool locus. What can we obtain if we do the same work in military perspective? You see exactly the same parameters. The difference is that the circle in the horizontal plane, is represented in true dimension. If we go back to the toolbar and use the trace of geometry trace of this segment and endpoint if we can, no, not in this position. If we drag A, you obtain the representation here of a cylinder. If we use the trace tool of point M and drag it, we obtain the upper circle, which is seen in true dimension. Let's go now to the page sorter and see how we can obtain these figures in military perspective or in parallel perspective using the tool Locus. Let's go back here. You see that instead of having sliders for A, R or A, we have constructed a segment having 10 centimeters as length. We have constructed a point R here and measured the distance between this point and this point, got this number stored in a variable called RA. Here we have constructed a segment having nearly 3.6 centimeters, a bit more, and a point on this segment, measure the distance again, which is here. We have displayed this formula with the tool text 100 times A and evaluate this expression for this value of A and obtain this number we have called AN, but not attached to the variable AN. Why have we done that? Because if this distance changes, it changes between 0 and 3.6. Multiplied by 100, we obtain a number changing from 0 to 360, which represent angles in degrees. And we have done exactly the same thing, calculated these two numbers with R, which is RA, and A, which is AN in this case. The interest is that the representation we have seen before with traces and obtained here can be obtained with Locus. Let us see how we did that. Let us delete this Locus. Let us delete this Locus. Let us delete this Locus. And let us go back to the toolbar, use the tool Locus, and if we ask the Einspar what is the locus of this segment when this point moves, we obtain the presentation of the cylinder. What about the locus of point M when this point moves? Upper circle. Locus of this segment when this point moves? The cone. We have later to change the color. If we go back to the previous construction, we can go back to what we had at the beginning. If we come back to the page sorter and come back to the military perspective with the same technique, here is what we obtain. You can see that we can change the position of the axis of the horizontal plane. We can change to the height of the cone and the cylinder here with this slider we have not used before, which is possible also with the military perspective, changing Z here and here.